everyone, and a very warm welcome to WS Cube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered how we can scrap a data from a table. In our today's session, we are going to talk about a mini project where we will be scrapping a data from a Tata IPL auction stats. So guys, how we can do it, let's have a look on that. Before we start it, I would like you all to try it by yourself. Like, we have learned how we can scrap a data from any table in our previous session. Now, by using the same method, try to scrap a table from a Tata IPL auction stats. And if you're unable to do it, then you can watch this whole video to get the answer. So here I have this table where we have auction stats. For example, we have team, funds remaining, overseas players and total players. This is how we have the data. Also, we have over here top buys and everything. So whatever table you want to scrap, you can scrap. Let's start with this one. So for that, first of all, let's copy the URL. So I'll just copy the URL. Let's come back to our code and let's import all the required libraries. For example, import requests, import pandas, SPD, and from BS4, import beautiful soup. Once we are done with this, let's create a variable called as URL and let's write over here that requests, or r is equals to requests, not re but requests dot, not request but get, and we will be passing our URL here. Inside the URL, let's pass the link as well and let's wait for the response as well. So let's print r, and as soon as I run it, I hope it gives us 200. So it gives the response as 200. That means we can scrap the data. Now let's make our soup. Let's cook our soup. That soup is equals to beautiful soup. Inside this, we'll write r.text, comma, lxml. Once we are done with this, now we have the code of whole page over here. Let's go back to our website, and just like how we have done it before, we'll use the same method. That let's click on inspect. Let's go somewhere near team by using the navigation bar. And close to this, you can see over here, we can easily find our table tag. So we have our table tag here. Okay, now first thing that we need to obtain from the table tag is the header. So let's copy the class and let's go back to our program. So table is equals to soup dot find table tag, comma, inside this we'll be passing our class underscore is equals to, and we'll paste our table tag. Let's print the table. And as soon as I run it, this is how the output looks like, that we have our whole table which says team, funds remaining, overseas players and total players. Once we are done with this, we need to get the header. For header, I'll be writing header is equals to table dot find, actually find all. What do we need to find from this table is that we need a header. The header is there in our th tag. As you can see over here, we have the team, funds, overseas player, they are all in our th tag, which is just like how we have done it before, that we have a th tag here. And let's go back, and here we have th, that find all th. Let's print header and let's see what all data we are getting. Let's also put this thing in a comment box. Now if I run it, everything with the head is here, that is our team, we have funds remaining, we have overseas players, and lastly we have total players. Now let's iterate it inside the loop. For that, I'll be writing for I in header colon, we will create name is equals to, or title is equals to I dot text, and let's append it in an empty list. So for the empty list, I'll be writing, let's say titles is equals to an empty list, and let's append it here by writing titles dot append the title, and let's print the titles list by writing print titles. Now as soon as I run it, this is how the output looks like, that we have team, funds remaining, overseas players and the total players. Once we are done with this, the next thing that we need to do is we need to add it as the column heads. For adding it as a column heads, we will be creating a data frame. Data frame is equals to pd dot data frame. Inside the data frame, we will be passing our columns. So columns is equals to this titles table. So I'll be writing titles. Actually, it's not a table, but it's a list. So title, not exactly title, but titles. Okay. And if I try to print it as well, let's print the data frame as soon as I run it. This is how the output will look like, that we have an empty data frame and we have columns and we have no index right now because no values are there inside it. Okay, so let's remove all these print statements. We do not need them right now. Now, what do we need to obtain is that we have got these tables from here. We have the table heads. Now we need to obtain the table rows, and from the table rows we need to obtain the TD. That means every row has TDs, 4 TD, that is Chennai Super Kings and the amount and the 8 overseas players and the 25 players in total. Okay, so this is what we need to obtain. For that, you can just click on the navigation bar. Let's go for the first row, and I think I need to click it again. So first, for our first row, as you can see, it's in a TR and we have all these TRs. So we need to iterate inside these TRs. To iterate inside these TRs, we will again go back and find all the TRs by writing rows is equals to table dot find all. We will be finding everything with the TR tag, and let's print the rows as well. So print rows, not R but rows. And as soon as I run it, you will again notice that the same thing will happen that happened previously, that the header will also come over here. So what we need to do, we need to iterate it inside a loop by writing for I in rows, and the index should start from 1, so 1 colon, and it should go up to the end. And here what we are looking for, we are looking for our TD tags here. So TD tag is table data. So let's get back over here. And as you can see, if I open this, we will find a TD tag. Inside this TD, we have a div tag, okay, which has our Chennai Super Kings. And then we have another TD here and another TD and another TD over here. So we need to look for our table data tags. So if you want to find the table data tags, the same method is there, that again we will be writing data is equals to I dot find all, and we need to look for the TD tags. So in the double quotes we will be passing the TD tags. Let's print this data right now. So if I run it as of now, it will give me all the data, and in this format that right now we have Chennai Super Kings. And then we have Delhi Capitals, and as you can see, it's not starting from our header as of now. Okay, now we do not have to print this. What we need to do, we need to get a data of each row. To get the data of each row, we will be creating a variable called as row. Inside this, we will be writing the same thing that we did before, that tr.text is for loop, that for tr in data. That we need to iterate in this data, and we need to get the text from here, that each text that we are obtaining from here. And let's print the row, and as soon as I run it, so now we have obtained the data in this format, that we have Chennai Super Kings and this is the price and this is all things. And again you can see there are backslashes in it. Let's add it to a data frame and also add it to our CSV. Let's see how does these backslashes in n looks like over there. And if they don't look good, then in that case, we will remove them. So for that, I'll just remove this line as well. And I will be writing the same thing that we did before, that first of all, we need to create the length of the data frame. For that, L is equals to DF, or length of data frame. For length of data frame, we will be writing length of data frame, and we need to append this data there. So at the location of data frame, so DF.LOC. What location? The location of this L, we will add a row is equals to row, and lastly print the data frame. And if I run it, this is how it looks like. So we have a data frame now, and if I add it to CSV file, let's have a look on how does it looks like. So df.toCSV, and here we will be passing auction stats 2022, and what auction stats? IPL auction stats 2022.csv. Now I'll not print this thing, but I will or we can just keep it printed as well. And if I run it and open my folder over here, you will see we have IPL auction stats 2022.csv. I have more of them, but today the one which is created today is this one. So if I open this and let's just wait for it to load, it's showing me some previous data here. So once it gets loaded, as you can see over here, because of those backslashes and n, the team name is not visible over here. So how to remove those backslashes and n? For that, we have a very simple method. Let me teach you that method as well. So for this, what we are going to do, as we know that in each row, our first TD has this backslashes and n. So let's create a variable over here called as first underscore TD. First TD is equals to, again, we will be using the same method that I dot find all. Not find next, but file underscore all. What do we need to look for? We are looking for the TD tags, but which TD tag? The one that comes on the first number. So again, we will write over here dot, and before dot, because as I said, we need to look it for the first one, I'll be writing one here, and the TD should come inside the double quotations. And from here, we will be looking for that exact place where we have our data. So let's open it. And here we have, as you can see over here, that even in the TD tag, if I open this, we have a div tag. In our div tag, we have Chennai Super Kings written like this. So what I need to do is I need to get this div tag here. So let's copy this. And from this tag, I will be extracting this data. Okay. So I need to ignore this image thing. Because of this image, you can see as we have an image over here, that is why this backslash n is coming. So I need to ignore this thing, and I need to go for this class. So let's copy this and come back to our code. And here again, we will write dot find, where we will be passing our div, and the class would be class underscore is equals to, in the double quotes, we will be passing the class dot text we need to obtain, and also we need to use the strip method to remove all the backslashes over here. That means a backslash and n over here. So the default value over here for the strip method is a backslashes. If there were commas, if there were hashes or any other thing, in that case you would have provided it in this way. Like if it had hashes, you would have written it like this. But because space is the default value, we will be writing dot strip. Now, once we have used dot strip, also we need to remember that in this TD also, because we have found all our first TD inside this first TD thing, right? So this should also start from one index. Okay. And lastly, the first TD will be inserted on the starting of this row. So we will be writing row dot insert on zero index. We will be inserting what? First TD. And now let's run it and see how does it looks like. And I'll also change it to part 1, or I'll just write 001. So as soon as I run it, object has no text. Let me just check it. It says object text has no attribute text. Object has no attribute text. Maybe it's the reason over here is, I guess, the TD is on number 0, find all for this. And if I run this again, yeah, it's working now. So basically what we need to do is I dot find all TD, and we are talking about in the table data also, we are talking about zero index. So instead of one, we need to put zero over there, that we are talking about the zero index. That means first column of each row. So here we are talking about the first column of each row dot find, and here we have got the output. And now I guess we have it in our folder as well. So 001, let's open this, and if I double click this, so yeah, now we have everything. That we have the name of the teams, we have the funds remaining, we have overseas and the total players. And I hope it is clear to you that how we have done this program, how we have completed it, and how we can remove the backslashes and n, which we can also do for, we can use the similar method for our previous table as well. So in our previous session also, we had some similar issue, and if you want to strip the backslashes from there, then you can use the similar method over here. Then you can use the similar method that we have used over here. So I hope you guys have no doubts and no questions. And in our next session, we will be working with dealing with the multiple pages using Beautiful Soup. So stay connected, guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.